Let us now recall lesson number 2, that is, let us use the graticule. So, in earlier lesson, we have studied what is a graticule and use of it, isn't it? Now, in this lesson, in detail, we will study how to make use of the graticule. So, here we had seen they had given us a world map and they had asked us some questions and we have answered that, isn't it? Later on, the main concept what we learned in this lesson was, here we have learned how to describe the world map or how to do the description of any place or the location with the help of the world map. Yes, so, or you can also use a globe, world map to determine or to describe any location or any region. So see children, first thing what we had learned, that was, we had learned describing the location of a place. Yes, to describe a location of a place, we usually need one parallel and one meridian. Okay, so always remember, to describe or to locate any place, we always require one parallel and one meridian. Okay, and when we use one parallel and one meridian, we are able to show the location of a place. Now, if we want to describe the extent of a region, what we have to do, if we want to describe the extent of a region, then we need two parallels and two meridians. Now suppose this is a region. Now I want to describe its extent, means from where to where this region is. Then I will require these two parallels, one and two, and these two meridians, one and two. Okay, so always remember, to describe the extent of a region, we require two parallels and two meridians. Now children, we had afterwards learned how to describe the extent of linear feature. Linear feature means what? Rivers, roads, lakes, etc. Now if you want to describe it, then you need to consider the latitude and longitude of their terminal points. Means, see here, now suppose this is a river. So you need to describe its latitude and longitude of the terminal points. So terminal point means the start point and the end point. So you will require the latitude and longitude of the starting point and latitude and longitude of the ending point. And then you are able to describe the extent of the linear feature. Then we had studied more about it by using the Brazil map. Yes, Brazil physical map. And next important thing what we had learned in this lesson, that is important parallels and meridians. So children, we had learned, first we will recall the important parallels. So always remember, 0° parallel is one of the important parallel. It is called as an equator. Next we have these two parallels, which are at 23° 30' south and 23° 30' north. Northern one is called as Tropic of Cancer and southern one is called Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, after this we have, what do we have? If you will see the next one, at 66, this parallel, circular one, at 66° 30' north and 66° 30' south. At north we have Arctic Circle and south we have Antarctic Circle. And then the next important parallel is at the poles, that is 90° north and 90° south. So these are the important parallels. Okay, now, so depending on the parallels, there are different seasons. Yes, so we have learned how the sun rays reaches this area and how the distribution of heat is done in these regions. Yes or no? So near equator on 2 days they receive perpendicular sun rays from 23 degree north to 23 degree south. In this area they receive perpendicular sun rays on any 2 days. Okay, then at 66 degree 30 minutes north and south, this is also one of the important parallel, and there the daytime lasts within the limit of 24 hours. Later on we had studied that depending on the seasons, sometimes the daytime can be greater than 24 hours in the area near the polar circles. Okay, so always remember students, the maximum duration of sun's appearance in the sky can be of 6 months. Okay, so appearance means the existence of the sun in the sky is for the 6 months, not more than that. Got it? And later on we have studied that due to this intensity of sunlight, we are having varieties in plants and regional animals. Okay, so that all things we had learned here. Yes or no? So we have also learned that because of the duration and intensity of sunlight, we have different temperature zones on the earth. Then next we had learned about the important meridians. So children, the important meridians are 0 degree or prime meridian. Okay, 0 degree longitude or prime meridian is also one of the important meridian, and because of that we are able to fix the global standard time and also to coordinate standard time of different countries. And students, this 0 degree longitude or prime meridian is also called as Greenwich meridian, and it is used, global standard time is whatever it fix, it is also called as Greenwich mean time. Okay, then the next important meridian we had studied, that was 180 degree meridian, which is exactly opposite to prime meridian. And this 180 degree meridian is used, or the main purpose of it is the international date line is marked with reference to this meridian, and about this I have explained you in detail in the video. Now after the important parallels and important meridians, so the next important point what we are going to learn, that is the great circle. So when two longitudes, opposite longitudes, join each other in this way, one longitude and one more longitude, a circle is formed, that is called as a great circle. So always remember, all pairs of opposite meridians form great circle. Means opposite meridians, like this, all pairs of opposite meridians form a great circle. And one more great circle we have, that is an equator. Okay, so children, the equator as well as all the pairs of opposite meridians form great circle. Now great circles, what is its use? Its use is to find the minimum distance between any two places on the surface of the earth. Okay, and this think a little and all we have discussed in detail in our video. So now one more important and interesting point what we are going to revise, that is about the Vatican City. Vatican City is one of the smallest country in the world. And see children, the extent of that region or that city is only 0.44 square kilometer. So you can think how small that country will be. And where it is located? It is within Italy, on the Italian peninsula. Yeah, so from west to east and also from north to south, you cannot see more difference. There is no difference in the degrees or the minutes of the latitudes or the longitudes, but there is difference only in seconds. So you can have an idea how small that country is, and also you can understand the use of the smaller units of minutes and seconds in angular measurement. So this was the revision what we have revised about the lesson number 2. I hope you have understood it. So children, watch the videos carefully and surely these videos will help you to understand the lessons, both the lessons, in a quick review. Okay.